Morning, students. So welcome back to your online class. In the last class, we have completed the political science chapter Constitution. And in today's class, I've told you that I'm going to take the sociology part. And the first lesson of your sociology is family. Okay. So please open page number 76, students, in your textbook. Yeah. 76. Sociology. Okay. Family. The chapter called family. What do you understand by family? Family means what, students? The family itself, it's happiness. Isn't it? So if you are along with your parents, like mom, dad, sister, brother, grandmother, grandfather, all this, what they get? They get happiness for you. Isn't it? So the family itself, it's said to be a happiness. Isn't it? So let us see what it has been discussed according to the, in this chapter, what exactly the family means, what are the rules and regulation by the government, and what the parents has to give to the children. Everything we will study in this chapter, students. So come back to your chapter. In this chapter, what we'll be learning? We'll be learning about meaning of the family. What actually it means. Second point, we'll be learning about the characteristics of the family. Third point, we'll be learning about the types of family. Fourth point, we'll be learning about the characteristics of the joint family. Okay, these are the four points what we'll be learning in the family. First, let us discuss about meaning of the family. What exactly the family means? Family. The man has formed many social institutions to fulfill the basic needs. Is that true or not? Yes. Because we people being a human being, man and women, what we have established a social institution to fulfill only the basic needs. Basic needs like what? Food, water, shelter, plus education. Understood. So among these institutions, the family is the most important one. Through family, it's a small institution. Family is said to be a small institution. It is called the basic institution of the society. Family itself, what it is said, it's a basic institution of the family. Understood. Where the man will provide the food, water, shelter, plus education for the people who resides in the family. All the activities of the social society are conducted on the basis of the family, and the members of the family are the members of the social institutions also. The people who are the members of the family, like father, mother, brother, sister, they're also members of the institution also. By understanding the meaning and the characteristics of the family, we can compare the meaning of it. The word family is derived from the Latin word called familis. From where it has been derived? It is derived from Latin word called familis. Understood? Which means to serve. What it means? Means to serve. What actually the familis means? A Latin word which means to serve. That means look after do's and don'ts of the family. By this we can come to know that there were also other members along with the father, mother, children in the ancient families. Today, the other members are not there in the family. The other members, nothing but grandfather, grandmother, co-brother, co-sister, auntie, nephew, everywhere there. It was called a joint family, where if it is more than 4 to 5 people, it is said to be a joint family, isn't it? So in nowadays, we are not seeing that joint family because they're all got separated. Why? Because their ancestors, that means father, mother, will be residing in their native, and only husband, wife, children will be staying in the city. Why? Because to adopt the basic necessity called the education and employment. Understood? Like that, they are dividing among themselves. Okay. The word family is derived from the Latin word familius, which means to serve. By this, we come to know that there were the other members along with father, mother, children in the ancient families. In today, the other members of the families, family members, now the families which have no children but have only the father, mother, the families that have adopted children there also. That means for particular families, they don't even have the children. What they do, they just go adopt the child. The relationship of the family members, it's a determination of the kinship. The members includes marriage, kinship, or the adoption, and these members live under the same house under this, according to this status, as when wife, father, mother, son, daughter, brother, sister perform the role and create a culture. That means at home, if they after once they get a marriage, if they don't have the child, they just get the adopted child and they just have the relationship like a husband and wife. Sister and brother, sister and sister, like that. Okay. The living together of husband and wife with the children without the with children or without the children for a long time is said to be a family. The main base of the family is the kinship and the emotions related to it. The family, apart from nurturing the children and the procreation, that involves itself in the process of socialization of its members so that they can be a part of a large society. Which means the family directly a social behavior, dressing, rituals, and other issues of its members. What exactly you learn from the family? The family, see, family, it's like, you know, it's like a, like this, a, you know, chalk box. This is an empty chalk box, you know, here, I'm telling you, it's an empty chalk box. Father is the head of the person. Okay, he is the head of the person. He'll be residing her home, and the mother, he just get married to a girl, and the girl will become a wife to a person. Understood? So she'll be a mother for the family. That means wife of that husband. So husband and wife relationship, how it is holding? It is holding in a something, a container of the society said to be a family. I can tell you in this way. And later on, they'll have kids. Kid number one, kid number two, kid number three. So they have got three kids. Even though these three kids, with or without kids also, this family exists in the society where it is. It is in the society. Understood? So while being in a society, they have to follow some relative things. That means how the husband should speak to a wife, or how wife should give the respect to the husband, or how three children, how they have to be cooperative among themselves and co-understanding in each and everything. Like that, they'll be teaching stage by stage how the mutual understanding and mutual respect and the mutual behavior should be taught in a house called a family. Understood? Whatever today we learn as a student or as a children in a family or in a school, so that will be gifting for the future things, isn't it? That means our social behavior will be reflecting in the society also. If we are kind enough, showing the love, concern to the needy people, that behavior, if we cultivate from the family, if that root which has come from the family, definitely that lead, that seed, I can tell you, that particular seed will become a good crop in a society, for the future society. This is actually the society what it is giving. I mean, this is what actually the family, what it is giving for the society. What it is teaching? It is teaching, first thing is behavior. Is that true or not? It has been clearly said and it has been proved in nowadays, in coming days, what things what we have proved is, there was a word which is said that, you know, house is the first preschool for the kid. And mother is a first teacher for a kid. That today we are, how it has happened is, yes, from last 2 years we are seeing the same thing. So house itself has become the educational institution for us, and our parents who are helping for our online classes, and they have become a teacher for us. That means they are between, they are making us to understand the concepts from our end as well as from the teacher end itself. So what is the role of the parents? They are teaching us. They are the teacher for you. Understood. So we have proven in coming days or nowadays what it has been said before, and today what we are leading due to this coronavirus. Understood. First thing is behavior, what they'll be teaching, and they'll be teaching about the dressing. So they'll be teaching the dressing sense, how we have to dress and go for the temples. For example, any holistic places, can we just wear the torn jeans with a sleeveless t-shirt with a half covered kind of cloths to the holistic places or the temples? Can we do that? No, it is strictly prohibited. The women's has to be dressed up with a sari or a salwar, and the men's has to be dressed up with pyjamas or the shirt and pant, isn't it? That is what the culture we are giving to our children. Dressing sense, rituals. What do you mean by rituals, students? Rituals means the performing things in the family. Understood. So, while doing the puja, there is a certain ritual what we have to follow. The puja should be done, it should be done in this time only, this way only, this flower only should be organized to the particular god. Like this, the rituals, not only puja, it could be, you know, performing, you know, festival at home, preparing, you know, good sweets, how it has to be prepared. And it could be, you know, rituals of, you know, when the new baby has born, there will be certain rituals, the day 1, day 5th, day 9th, day 16th, like that they have got a ritual. That means day first they don't get bath, but day 5th they'll get a bath for that kid, and later on they'll have, you know, puring ears, understood? They have kesh mundan. These are all the rituals. From the age of birth till we die, there are many rituals where we have to follow. But this is what the family people will be teaching us. Knowingly or unknowingly, directly or indirectly, we'll be learning all these things from our family. Is that true or not? Yes. It's very much true enough, students. Why? Because what we are today, that is what the culture it has been given from our parents. This is how our parents were being there in their in-laws' houses, or this is how they are born and brought up by their moms and dads. That is what they are giving us. Similarly, what we are learning from our mom and dad, definitely will be giving to our children in the same way, isn't it? So this is what the family upholds in the society. Next comes the characteristics of the family. Characteristics. By understanding the characteristics of the family, we can comprehend the importance of the family. That means by understanding this, we can just see how it is important. See, family, it's a universal. First point, we'll be learning. Family is universal. That means wherever you go, entire universe, wherever you travel across universe, you go, you know, Antarctica, Andaman, America, you know, Australia, Argentina, whichever places you go. But you cannot see the person without having a bond. Why? Why? Because the bond is nothing but the relationship. What it could be, the relationship, it could be mom and a dad, it could be son and a daughter, it could be daughter-in-law or son-in-law, or it could be brother-sister or sister-brother. These kind of a bond, wherever you go, wherever you travel in the universe, you can find that. That is what it has been stated in one word, family is universal. Because no man will be brought up or no man will be born without having this relationship. Will you accept? Yes, you have to accept this thing. Because yes, you and me know that if you and me are talking each other or communicating something today in the online class only because of our parents, because of our parents only today we are here. If they have made up a mind not to have a kid, take a adopted kid, means today we wouldn't have been doing this action right in front of you. Is it true or not? Yes. That is what your family is said to be universal. Let us see what it has been stated in the textbook. Through it varies the according to the specific geographical nature, time period, the family is found in all societies. Yes, it could be the geographical. That means, as I said to you, talking about the latitude and longitude, even though if we travel across longitude and latitudinal ways also, the family is universal. Usually, the families follow the fixed pattern, issuing like a marriages, nurturing, kinship, property rights. Generally, the members who belong to the particular family reside in the same place and share a same roof. That means the family, it's nothing but the same kind of a people who are related with a blood related, who stays in the same home under the same roof. Roof is nothing but under the same roof. How many people they stay? They said to be a family. Understood. What is the second characteristic? The second characteristic, it is said to be, it is the basic unit for all the social activities. Unit for all social activities. Is it true? Yes. Because it is a very basic unit. It is a stepping stone, I can tell you. It is very much basic unit for all social activities. That means if a person which will be born in the Hindu family, example, what and all the rights and duties, what and all rituals he'll be learning. For example, normal Hindu person and the Brahmin person. So Brahmin person, what he'll be learning at the age of 3 or 4, he'll be started chanting the Vedas, Upanishads, and he'll be started learning all those Veda mantra, all those patanas he'll be doing at the age of 4 or 5, and he'll be by the time of 6 or 7, he'll complete one stage of his paranga, all those Vedic studies. But the normal Hindu person who was born and brought up, what he'll be doing, he just comes to four years, he comes to KG class and start learning ABCD. But what Brahmin person, he learns the Vedic, he'll just go through with this Vedic things also, and he still continues studying in the school also. That is how the basic culture it is. See, being a Brahmin, they'll teach all the Upanishads, Vedas towards their son. But being a normal Hindu, he'll just go according to the society, what the other people will be doing. Understood? So that means the basic root itself, it's from family, isn't it? That is what the teacher, that is what I've said to you. So home is the first institution, educational institution. It could be in any way, any educational way, not only studying in the book. It could be behavior or dressing sense, or learning something good things from the society, from the family. And mother and father are the first teachers for the kids, not other gurus. They are the first guru for the kids. That is what it is said, that it is a basic unit of all social activities in terms of performing the festival or celebrating the national festivals, how it has to be celebrated, why on Independence Day we are going to fly our Indian flag, what does it mean. Everything, all kind of a knowledge will be given to a kid by the family. That is what it is, a basic unit of all social activities, it has been said. Every activities of the social institutions starts from the family. The political, it could be political. Teaching who is our first CM, or teaching who is our present CM. Economical, where we are standing. What is our economical thing? Educational and several other activities of the society begin from the family. During the earlier times, the family was sending its members to participate the important activities of the local community. Now, due to the increased complexity of the social life, the many functions of the family has been assigned to the various other social institutions. Now, in the last few years, okay, they were sending their children to participate in the local competitions. Like if some community arranged some competition, they used to send their children. But now it has come very complex way. They wanted to send their children for the big institution, learn some good things, like it could be the Abacus, the genius of maths. Isn't it? They want in that way. Why? Because it is very competitive world what today you and me are leading. And we can just go and compete with the local communities. We have to compete to the international boards. So that is where today the parents are rushing and taking their kids to the good international standard boards to get modified with their knowledge or gain some good knowledge. This is how it has been stated. Third one, we have continuous responsibility and social accountability. What is the third characteristics? We have continuous responsibility and social accountability. What exactly is this? The family teaches the members how to behave, discharge the specific responsibility. It trains its children to how to live harmoniously with the neighbor. Along with this, it educates the few social responsibility. For example, it educates on how to keep the drinking water sources clean. Not only the students see, which says that it shows that how to communication. Main thing is communication. If you and me doesn't speak, how we'll get to know what it is running in your mind and what I wanted to say, isn't it? So basic community, for example, how we have to talk to the elders. We have to respect them. We have to show some concern towards them. And we have to speak very in the low voice with them, isn't it? So when it comes to the professionals, we have to be in the commanding way. Not only the commanding way, it is very passionable, you know, kind of a thing what we have to go with the, you know, the people who are working. Isn't it? The politeness should be there. The politeness plus commandability we have to showcase in the competitive world when it comes to the work. Isn't it? So all these things will be learning. The continuous responsibility. See, family or the society, it is not just one chapter we deal only for today. Because we'll be dealing all the day, all the time, 24/7. It could be inside the house or it could be the outside the house. That is what the continuous, our responsibility is continuous. It is not ended by 1 or 2 days. It doesn't have any time frame at all, students. It is a continuous responsibility. Every day is a learning process when it comes to the responsibility, when it comes to the society, the family. The continuous responsibility and social accountability. Whatever we do, it will be accounting. For example, what the media people, they'll be covering all the news around us. Isn't it? So there'll be, if you do some good things also, it will be covered and it will be telecasted. If you do some bad things also, it will be covered and it will be telecasted. So everything we will be accounting it, accountability will be kept. Understood? For example, teaching a kid how to clean the water resource or teaching a kid how to get the drinking water to the elders, isn't it? In the very optimistic way. Understood? So what is our fourth characteristic? The fourth characteristic, bringing up and nurturing. See, the fourth characteristic, it says that bringing up and nurturing, it's not a small task. It is not a certain period. Like the parent's role, it's like from the day one of the baby born till he succeeds in his life and he just attains his, the last breath in his life, also the parents' responsibility will be there. They always concern in there what they need, what they don't need, how they have to make the kids to understand. So bringing up, it's nothing but only feeding with a food or shelter or education, giving them a good morals about the society and how they have to become a idols of the society future. That is what the bringing up and the nurturing takes a part here. See, the family creates a basic right and the responsibility with regard to the children. And it is also protected them to create the way nurturing and bringing up the children and makes them literate. And it is a duty of the family to take care of the elders during their old age. As I told you, not only teaching the kids only in the educational concepts, but also teaching them moral things so that how they'll be there in the young generation. And they'll teach how the old people should be looked after. Everything do's and don'ts they'll be teaching in the bringing up and nurturing. And fifth point, we have got teaches social behavior. Teaches social behavior. What exactly it says? The childhood is adolescent and there is very important stages in the process of socialization. The child learns its mother tongue in the family. It understands the social life around it, and throughout the masters of mother tongue, the children develop as per the social situation around the family. The family teaches the children about the ways interacting with the elders, peer group, and this means the social behavior demands taboos. Indirectly controls the children. The family teaches the behavior like a friendship, freedom, security during the childhood, adolescent, at this age. Okay. So fifth point, teaching the social behavior. See, teaching social behavior is nothing but teaching a kid at what age, how he have to be. First thing, child learns its mother tongue and it learns the behavior at home, how the mother will be there. If I cry, if a child cry, what the mother will be feeding? The mother will be feeding with the milk or a food, isn't it? If something, if I need, means how I have to tell, until unless know to talk. I have to cry, I have to show that thing I need it. All these things, it will be taught. It will be learning by itself how the thing should be taken from others. Or they'll be learning the mother tongue first and foremost. Like that, teaches the social behavior. Mother, she'll be teaching everything. That is what I said, the mother is the first teacher to a kid. So she teaches in all aspect of behavior. It depends upon the age wise. When the baby is small, she teaches in the whatever the things a baby should know. And when it comes to the adult age, the the mother will be telling what is right, what is not right, what the child has to go in which way. Everything from top till the end, they'll be teaching everything when it comes to the social behavior. So we have got the sixth point, the six characteristics I want to discuss in deep in our next class, students. So in today's class, we have learned the concept of the family, what exactly it means, and the five characteristics of the family. So please read the textbook, make a note of all these points so that it will be helpful for your remembrance. Okay, so thank you, children. Have a great day. So we'll be dealing the sixth characteristic in our next class. So thank you. Have a nice day.